Hey everyone, today I wanted to bring you into the kitchen so we can make the kale Caesar salad together because this is a little more complicated of a recipe, but it is fabulous tasting and incredibly healthy for you. One of the reasons I love the salad so much is that there is a good amount of protein in it to make it substantial, to keep me full for a meal, and getting tons of greens, tons of fiber. If you are backed up in any way, eat the salad and you'll be good to go. Promise you that. Okay, so I have everything out. I'm gonna just make it with you. I'll talk as I go, and feel free to ask any questions you have in the comments below so that I can answer them and help you out as well, or the team can too. So, all right, first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna make the garlic cashew aioli. I'm using my Vitamix containers because they are incredible. These are their blending bowl set. I use them for cashew cream mostly and salad dressings. First thing I did was I soaked the cashews, raw cashews, in water. It's been about an hour and a half, and I'm gonna drain them. All right, I'm gonna put them into my blending bowl. Next, I need my garlic clove. So not this whole thing, but just separate it out. That didn't work too well. All right, what I do, once I get the clove, I just smash it with the side of a knife to break it open, and it makes it easier to peel. But this one is an old garlic that I've had in the back of my pantry, so it's not as fresh. But there you go, peels off just like that. That's not how you do it, but that kind of worked. I'm gonna get off the floor, 10 second rule here, put the garlic in. Now I need 1 teaspoon of Dijon mustard. Tip, I always use more. I think Dijon is fabulous, it's nice and creamy. I do a little bit more. And also another tip, I don't measure anything. So I just eyeball it, but I've been doing this long enough to where that works for me. Feel free to measure everything if you want to start with, and then add in more as you go. Last thing I'm gonna do is a squeeze of lemon. Right into that. All right. One tip I have, depending if you're using a food processor or a blender on this, if you're gonna use a normal blender, you're gonna need to quadruple this recipe so there's enough substance to get the blender blade working. That is why I like this new blending bowl kit, because I can use so much less and it still works. But if this does not blend, I'm gonna be adding some water to it, which sometimes happens depending how long I soak the cashews and also how much Dijon I used. See, I'm just pulsing it just to get it started. Okay, I think it's gonna work. Yeah. So once it just starts to spin like that, I take it off the base, add some water. Let's see. Yeah, it's gonna need some water. Which I have right here. Because that was about a tablespoon of water. With this recipe, you want it to be creamy. I'll also, I do this with my food processor too. I take it off and shake the thing down so all the ingredients can get back to the blade area, and then do it again. I don't know if you can see. There's still a little bit of chunks. Yeah. So, oh, but that is so fabulously delicious. I'm gonna add a little bit more water. You could also do more lemon juice if you want. I just need a little more something to whip it around. I could tell when it was really catching and working well. So this is the winning round right here. I don't know if I can show without spilling it, but no. So this is a successful garlic aioli sauce. full of protein, not full of junk. That's the way I like to do it here. Okay, now we're gonna move on to the kale. I always say one handful is a cup. So same thing when I'm making a smoothie, and if I'm gonna use a cup of spinach, all I do is I grab out one big handful and I call that a cup. So same thing we're gonna do with this salad. So you can see I'm just pulling out the stems and setting them aside. So I only have good greens right here. You can also, You can also use baby kale as well. If you just cannot stand kale, try baby kale. It's much more mild. It also has more nutrients because it's still in the growth phase. And it's just easier on your body to digest as well. Okay. All right, that's about 2 cups. So now I'm gonna chop it a little finer. Just because I don't like big pieces of salad. Like if I'm gonna take a bite, I don't want it to like fill up my whole mouth, and I just like little bites. You can even crump it together. Move this bag out of the way too. You can see them good. And you have to remember, I did not go to cooking school. I am an at-home mom. I just do what it takes to chop this kale. I'm sure you're cringing at my techniques, but maybe not. Maybe this is how you do it too. All I say is there's no right or wrong way to do it. As long as you do it, that's the most important piece. Okay, so we're gonna take our kale. I'll show you as I crumple it up, literally 2 bulging handfuls. Feel free to add more if you want to. All right, now we have our kale. Now we're gonna massage it. What this does, you won't need to do this with baby kale, but you will need to do it with the kale that we're using, is massage it with some oil, and it helps soften it up, makes it more palatable. I'm gonna just drizzle a little bit over it. And then I'm gonna wash my hands. Now I'm just gonna put my hand in here and I'm literally just crunching it. So I don't know if you can see, but I'm grabbing it and just squeezing. Grab and squeeze. Do it a few times. Keep going. I twist my hand. You can twist the bowl. Here, let's see if I can do it this way. Just go around and you'll begin to start to feel when the cell walls give and it gets a lot more gentle. Oh, man, I'm getting so hungry just doing this. So that took me about 30 seconds. We said 5 minutes at most in the suggestion, but I don't ever do that long. I don't have the patience for that. But you can get it super tender if you do. Now I'm gonna squeeze some lemon on top of it. What the lemon does is it helps cut the bitterness. So for the salad, that's what the lemon's gonna do. I also, whenever I make a kale smoothie, I always add a little bit of lemon or orange, something citrusy, pineapple even, and it really neutralizes that bite that comes with kale that you probably don't like. So that's a great hack to make it taste a little better. So we're gonna do half a cup of these. If you want to, you can always do roasted chickpeas. So take these, drain them, rinse them, drizzle with a little bit of olive oil, salt, and pepper, put it in your toaster oven or your oven, and bake it for about 20 minutes to get them popping. They're so delicious. You could put that on here too. It makes it more like a kale crouton, kale salad crouton. So I need half a cup. Once again, do I measure? No. So I like beans, so I'm gonna do a little extra. And now we're gonna mix in the dressing. So here's what it looks like up close. I think you can see it there. Just plop it in here. And then I also gotta get it out of this side. Oh yeah, delicious. Oh my gosh, you guys. So the dressing and the chickpeas are in here. Try to mix it up holding it. today, we are in for a treat. Okay, next step is adding the toppings. One of them is a vegan cheese sprinkle. It's like a vegan Parmesan cheese. What I love about it is there's protein in it once again. People say when you go plant-based or vegan that it's hard to get protein and your body needs protein. It most likely doesn't need as much as a lot of diets are suggesting at this point for weight loss, but you are getting sufficient protein on a plant-based diet. I promise you that. So we're gonna get into that step after I rinse this. Gotta dry it because this next part of the recipe is a crumble, so I don't want any liquid inside here. Let's just take that off. Okay, good. Got this on camera. Let's do. So for the cheese sprinkle, we need 2 tablespoons of almonds and cashews. Put them right in the bowl. You can also use a food processor or a blender for this. I typically quadruple this recipe and I keep it in a mason jar. I probably have some down here actually. Nope, I am out. So this is perfect time to make it. So I make a ton of it so then I have it on hand and I don't have to do this every time. But today we're just gonna make following the recipe so we can get through this challenge together. All right? Okay, so I did the almonds, cashews. We're gonna do the nutritional yeast. This is the kind I have from Bragg's. Nutritional yeast has B vitamins in it, which are essential for our bodies. They're also not found in most plant products, so this is a benefit to it. It also adds a cheesy, delicious flavor as well. It's an umami, like it adds a robust depth to recipes. This is also what you use if you're gonna make a vegan mac and cheese. So it has many uses in life. All right, now we're gonna add the garlic powder. I always add a lot of this. I love garlic, so I'm going all the way. And some salt. Salt, maybe 2 pinches. And I'm using Himalayan sea salt. Okay, everything's in here. The goal is to make a crumble. So you don't want it a powdery dust necessarily. You want a little, just crumbles. So I do it on puree, pulse. I do it on the pulse setting so that I can be in control and stop it when I want. Was it? All right, so I don't know if you can see it. If you're wondering, the blender I'm using is the Scent A3500. Here is our, maybe I'll get a spoon. I'll use this one. So you can see, can't get any closer, the texture of the final cheese sprinkle. So good. I need to even scoop it over. One thing with these bowls is you can actually, they have a lid that goes on it, so I can just store it like this if I don't need to use this again, which makes it really nice and not use as many dishes. But we are gonna make our kale salad right now. So I'm gonna serve it up on my plate. I'm doing half now and I'm gonna put half in a storage container. See if I can make some space here. Let's do, I have the garbanzo beans. Okay, pepitas. Yes. So I'm gonna do the cheese sprinkle. I'm doing kind of a lot because I like it. And then also pepitas, which are a certain kind of pumpkin seed that are so good. They're like airy, crispy, really good. Put those on top. There is our kale Caesar salad. Let me make my leftover container and then I'll taste it with you. Make sure that it did turn out well. For my leftovers, I'm using these containers right now. One, because they're an adorable color. Also, I forgot to mention my shirt. I wore my kale shirt for our kale salad day. So trying to be festive, keep this fun, right? Because I think healthy eating should be a blast and that we should enjoy what we're doing. All right, let me get some cheese sprinkle on top. You can wait to put the nuts, which I'm gonna do, until I'm gonna serve it because I don't want them to get moist. And yeah, that's a gross word anyway. All right, so my leftovers are here. I'll have them as a side with the dinner and good to go. But now let's try it. Let's see how good it is. Maybe I'll come closer. I don't know if this is gonna be too close. We're gonna do it. We're just gonna go really close together as I taste it. Yes, yes. I'm glad I did all that garlic because that's my favorite part. Mm-hmm. Can I see it? This is it. Amazing recipe. I cannot wait for you to try it. Thank you so much for being a part of this challenge. I am having so much fun with you. And of course, keep on going. Like, I hope you'll use these recipes over and over. I should probably finish chewing before I talk. Amazing programs that we offer, seasonal cleanses, meal planning. My blog is constantly being added with new recipes that are delicious because if it's not good, I'm not gonna put it on there. And yeah, but thank you for being a part of this. Make the salad, cross off your day 9 on the checklist, and maybe today will be your lucky day to win the daily prize. So, all right, bye.